Yeah, hi there. These comments are for Wynn, and I am Michael, the founder owner and the materials writer for all of your lessons at the 7-step system to pass the TOEFL IBT. And let me scroll down. You made a question at my website. So, you say, I have just 1 month to prepare for the test. My score in the last test was 68. My goal is 80. Can you help me? Yes, I certainly can help you, Wynn. Now, the question is, will you be able to reach your goal in 1 month? I'll be honest with you, it's going to be very close in your case. Most students, in my opinion, they usually improve their TOEFL score about 5 to 10 points for each month that they study, and that assumes that they're actually studying, that they're doing things each day to improve their academic English language abilities. So, in your case, I'm going to say you're probably looking, my best guess is 2 to 3 months, I think, because your English skills right now are a little bit lower with your TOEFL exam. And 80 is kind of it's a milestone, really. I mean, even getting 60 or 61 is a milestone if you're starting from very low levels. So you have to get to 60 or 61, then you get to 80 or 81, and then you try to get to 100. So, I think it's possible. Now, what I want to do here is give you some suggestions here, some things you can do. And think about my online course as it's a website with over 700 vocabulary, pronunciation, grammar, listening, reading, writing, and speaking lessons. So think of it this way. Even after 1 month, I can still help you improve your academic English language abilities even after you reach your goal of getting 80 or 81, right? So I'm assuming that you probably want to study at a graduate program here in the United States. So improving your English is even beyond the TOEFL exam, right? So consider using my course for at least maybe 2 or 3 months. I promise you, if you study my lessons, and particularly if you post pronunciation, speaking, and writing practice tests on a weekly basis, you will find that I will help you to address whatever your problems are, and I can recommend specific lessons to help you get better and you actually improve. So as you get into your study right now, let me give you some suggestions. So about 60% of your time right now, I'm going to recommend some things. I'm going to give you what's called a study plan. And my study plan I'm going to focus on just a few things. So first of all, read every day for about 45 minutes. That's really my first suggestion I give everybody. Practice listening every day for about 45 minutes. Number three, as you're doing the reading and the listening practice, you need to work on your note-taking, especially focusing on the main and the most important supporting points of the reading and the listening passages. Now, using your notes, I want you to write 3 250-word summaries each week. Now, if you're not sure how to write a summary, go to Google. Type in the keywords, how to write an academic summary. That'll get you going in the right direction. One thing I want you to remember for TOEFL, make sure that you're including voice markers as you explain the information. So you'll say things like, according to the reading passage. You'll say the speaker in the lecture claims. You'll say another point made by the author is. And finally, the reading passage says. So you want to make sure that you're acknowledging the sources that you write about. It's good to get into this habit as you do your speaking and your writing practice, especially, obviously, for the integrated speaking task. Now, also give maybe 3 60-second oral summaries. I think this is also going to be very helpful for you. So if you can do these first five suggestions, I think, are going to get you in the right direction. So the reading, listening, note-taking, the writing and the speaking practice, using your notes on the most important information in those passages, that's a good start. Now, my sixth suggestion is you can start going through my online course. You can use my course any way you like. If you use the different lessons for a month or so, it will help you to improve your academic English language proficiency, right? So because of your basic English skills, my recommendation is that you go through the vocabulary pronunciation, grammar first. Do those lessons first. And then seven, then you can do the listening and the reading lessons. That's my recommendation. And then you can do the speaking and the writing lessons. I think that's probably the best thing for you. Now, my guess is you have quite a few language issues you need to solve, so it's probably going to take you more than 1 month, maybe as many as three, I think, before you really master the content you need to master to improve your English. Now, if you want, after about 3.5 weeks or so, you can complete a full-length TOEFL IBT practice test. This is probably a pretty good idea for you. And this is a great chance for you to mark your progress. You can see how much you've improved since you started my program. Number two, you can refamiliarize yourself with the structure and the format of the TOEFL exam. And the third benefit of taking a IBT practice test, remember, this practice test is 5.5 hours long, right? So it's going to be similar to the actual TOEFL exam, is you develop the strength and the stamina needed for this type of English test. You learn how to concentrate for longer periods of time. So once you take the practice test, then you can make a decision. And your question is simple. Are you ready? You might say, well, am I ready to take the TOEFL exam based on my practice test score? All right, so those are my suggestions for you right now. And remember, these are just suggestions of how you can use my course. You can use it any way you like. Once you become one of my students, you'll have complete, unlimited access to all of my lessons. You can work on anything you want, whenever you want, as long as you have a good internet connection.